Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I am going to be talking to you a little bit about emotional eating. A lot of you listening to this message may not even understand that emotional eating may have something to do with why you have fibroids in the first place. Let me just tell you a little story. I have often, over my lifetime, just kind of stuffed my emotions and stuffed my feelings down. No matter how small or how large they were, I just kind of stuffed them or pushed them aside because I felt like I had to keep going. Or I think probably a better way of describing it is I thought that was what I was supposed to do with my emotions. So I would just push them aside and keep going. And pushing emotions aside does not make the emotions go away. I think in retrospect that I was doing myself a good a favor by saying, okay, I can just keep on going and it doesn't matter, you know, what these feelings are. Although I didn't really think that like consciously, but honestly, I don't think I knew that I was actually pushing my emotions aside either. I thought that, you know, those emotions that would come up, it was just kind of like, okay, that's life. What else am I supposed to do with them besides just push them aside and keep going? And I did that for so many years, and I can sometimes catch myself still doing that, pushing them aside, and then all of a sudden, then you're faced with all these feelings and uncomfortable situations in your heart when stuff comes up. So, without going into too much detail, my husband and I have been talking about some things lately, and every time he would talk bring up this particular topic, I would get all bent out of shape on the inside. Like I wouldn't get upset with him, but I would like it was almost like my insides would start flipping up inside, up and down. And I'm like, why am I getting all bent out of shape about this? And so I was looking at it, I'm like really asking God, like, what's going on here? Why am I getting bent out of shape about this? What's going on? And to make a long story short, turns out I never dealt with the root of why of that conversation. I never dealt with it. I never processed my emotions around it. And when you don't process your emotions around things, you can do yourself a disservice because what tends to happen, and I know this is what happened to me whenever from a young child, I would eat over my emotions. I would just stuff the emotion down and go eat something. I didn't realize I was doing it, but that's what I did. And I did that for a long time. And you can even do that with healthy food, believe it or not. You can do that with healthy food. So God showed me this scripture. It is Psalm 62, verse 8. That's Psalm 62, verse 8. And in a New Living Translation, I think this is what this is. It says, "Oh, my people, trust in him at all times. Pour out your heart to him, for he is your refuge. He is our refuge. Oh, people, trust in him at all times. Pour out your heart to him, for God is our refuge." So basically, when those emotions come up, no matter how big or small they are, we need to be pouring our hearts out to God and talking to him about him. Running to him and telling him all about how we're feeling about these particular things. Because if not, what happens is we find some type of an outlet to cope with those emotions that we have. And I, for one, have used food as that way to cope with those emotions, whether I knew I was doing it or not. I finally came to a revelation at one time. I finally came to the revelation that that's what I was actually doing. And so I did that so much that I was just eating and eating and eating over my emotions. And it wasn't normally healthy food whenever I was eating over my emotions. It was more like let me go to the drive-through, or let me go to the grocery store and make, you know, some meal that's going to make me feel good, or order pizza, or whatever I had to do to try to cope with those emotions, even though I was not conscious of me actually doing that. I was not conscious of my decision-making. That, like, I didn't say to myself, okay, I'm feeling bad about XYZ. So instead of taking it to God and dealing with it, I'm going to order a pizza. Like, I didn't think, that was not what I thought in my head. It's not. I just said, I'm going to order some pizza. And when I sat there and ate the pizza, it made me temporarily made me think about something else. And it doesn't always have to be food. It could be other things. It could be, you know, you watch porn, or you masturbate, or you smoke weed, or you drink alcohol, or that glass of wine that you have at the end of the night so you can wind down. That's another way of stuffing your emotions. And then when you have all these unhealthy behaviors that you are taking on, then what happens is it takes your body takes the brunt of it. And things like fibroids will show up. All those negative emotions will manifest themselves in some way, somehow. Say you got, you know, somebody did something to you, say someone did something to you and you are bitter and you're holding on to unforgiveness about it and you're not dealing with it. Let me tell you, all those emotions get stored in the body, and that's how we develop sickness and disease, because we're storing negativity in our body instead of processing it with God and going to Him for what we're supposed to do with those emotions. So I'm hoping that this is making sense to you. I know that this isn't a popular video to click on because it involves you looking at your stuff. And looking at our stuff is not easy, especially when it starts to come to a head and we are just inundated with all the emotions and pain that goes along with stuffing stuff for years. But it is worth going at it one by one so you can get free. So Father, in Jesus' name, I lift up my sisters here to you, God, and I just ask you to help them to recognize if they are stuffing their emotions. And if they are stuffing their emotions, Lord, I pray that you would help them to pour their hearts out to you and trust you to be their refuge. Trust you to be their answer to their prayers. Trust you to deliver them out of all of their troubles, Lord. And I pray, Lord God, that not one more emotion will be contributed to fibroid growth or polycystic ovaries or breast cyst or whatever may be brewing at the root of all of these negative emotions that we don't always know what to do with. And Father, I pray that you would bring healing to our souls, that you would heal us from the inside out, that you would help us, that you would cause us to think clearly, that we would catch ourselves if we are about to stuff an emotion, that we would catch it and then we would go straight to you about that emotion and that you would bring us relief. We thank you and praise you that you are our deliverer and that you are a refuge in our time of need, and that all we have to do is call to you and that you will answer us and show us great and mighty things that we do not know. So we thank you and praise you for what you're doing here. In Jesus' name. All right, ladies, I hope that this message has been a blessing to you. I have really enjoyed hearing your commentary from the comments, from the videos, the emails, and all those things that I have received from this 24 days of Christmas. I didn't know what it was going to look like in the beginning, But I'm grateful that the Lord is going to use this information that I'm presenting as a blessing to you. That is my prayer. That is my prayer. All right, ladies, lots of love to you. If you need help, there are resources down in the description box that can help you on this journey. Lots of love. Take care.